Hi guys, my name's Marty from letsbuildwp.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how to install WordPress on HostGator web hosting in 2024. Plus, I'll show you how to get a great discount on your hosting, and we also get a free domain name as well. So, if you're ready, let's get started. Okay, so before we can install WordPress, we first need to set up a HostGator account and register our domain name and hosting. If you've already done this, you can skip ahead to the time on screen now. Then for everyone else, we're going to open up our internet browser and go to HostGator.com. Or if you want to support this channel, you can use my affiliate link in the video description. I'll earn a small commission if you do this, and you'll also get a discount. Then, once we get here, we're going to hover over where it says Hosting at the top and click Shared Hosting. Then we just need to scroll down a bit, and this is going to show us the three different hosting plans that HostGator offer. If you're just getting started with WordPress, I'd recommend going for either the Hatchling plan or the Baby plan. And the only real difference between these two plans is the amount of websites we can have with each one. So with the Hatchling plan, we can have one single website, and with the Baby plan, we can have two. Now, as I'm only doing this for the tutorial, and I only need one website, I'm going to go for the Hatchling plan. Then, once we know which plan we're going for, we can click Buy Now underneath. That's going to bring us to this page, and this is where we're going to register the domain name we want for our new WordPress website. So we just need to type whatever we want for our domain name into this box at the top. And for this example, I'm going to type a blog about coffee. Then we can choose our domain extension over on the right, and I'm going to choose .com. So the domain name I'm registering here is ablogaboutcoffee.com. Then we just need to click the search icon to the right, and give it a few seconds to search. And as long as the domain's available, it's going to say primary domain here. But if it says the domain is unavailable, this means someone has already registered it and we'll need to choose something else. Then once we're happy with our domain name and we know it's available, we can scroll down and keep going until we get to this bit where it says domain privacy protection. Now, this is totally optional, and I normally just uncheck this box myself and haven't had any problems to date. But if you want to keep your site totally anonymous, you might want to check this box and add it to your bill. Then, under this, on the right, we're going to choose how often we'd like to pay for our hosting. Now, I know this is really going to depend on your budget, but I'd definitely recommend setting this to 12 months or higher if you can. And not only will this get us a much higher discount, which it does, but we'll also get our domain name for free if we go for 12 months or more up front. Then under this we just need to enter the details we want to use for logging into our HostGator account. And then underneath we can enter our personal billing information, so things like our name and address. And if we look on the right, we'll see that we can use either credit or debit card or PayPal. Then once we're done here, we can scroll down and we'll see it says add additional services. Now these are optional add-ons and I normally just uncheck them all myself, but you can have a read through them and see if there's any you want. Then just check the box beside them and they'll be added to your bill. Then once we're done here, we can scroll down to the bottom and review our order to make sure everything's correct. So here we can see that it's going to cost less than $60 for 12 months of web hosting. And the domain name is free. So this means it's only going to cost me around $5 per month to run my website, which is less than the price of a fancy coffee from Starbucks. Then if we look over on the left, we can see that HostGator offer 24/7 live chat and email support, and they also have a 30-day money-back guarantee. So there's really no risk at all. Then once we've reviewed our order, we just need to click Checkout Now at the bottom. And when we do, we'll either be brought to a payment screen or redirected to PayPal to pay for our order. So if you're following along at home, just pause this video until you've finished paying for your order, then come back and press play when you're done, and we'll carry on installing WordPress together. Okay, so after paying for our order, we'll find ourselves logged into the HostGator dashboard, which is where we'll be installing WordPress. Or if for whatever reason you need to get back here, you can just open up your internet browser and go to hostgator.com/billing. And then log in with your new account details that you just set up. Then from this screen, we're going to click where it says Hosting on the left. And this will show us any websites we already have. But as this is a new account, I don't have any yet. Then to install WordPress, we just need to click Add Site over on the right. Then make sure Install WordPress is selected at the top and click Continue. Now we can enter our site title, and don't worry too much about this for now, as we can always change it again later. Then click Continue on the right. Now we need to enter the domain name we're wanting to use for our WordPress website, which is going to be the one we just registered. So for me, this is going to be ablogaboutcoffee.com. Then if we click Continue, HostGator's going to start installing WordPress for us right away. This will usually only take about 30 seconds or so to complete, but sometimes it can take a little longer. Then once WordPress has been installed, we might get a message that reads, "This site is using a temporary URL until the domain is pointed at HostGator. If this is a new domain name, it might take a few hours to finish setting up." But once our new domain name is ready, it'll replace the temporary one right away without us needing to do anything else. Now we just need to click Log into WordPress on the right, which is going to open up the WordPress dashboard in a new tab. And this is where we can add any content or make any changes to our new WordPress site, which is now live online. All we need to do to visit it is click our site title in the top left. And this is going to show us what WordPress looks like when we first install it. And don't worry if yours looks a little different than mine, as sometimes they change up the default theme. But either way, it's just going to have some demo content on it for now, and it's ready for us to start customizing and adding content to. Then to get back to the dashboard, we just need to click our site title again in the top left. And I should point out here that if you registered your domain name from somewhere else or using a different HostGator account, you will need to point the domain to your new website before it will update. I'll link to a tutorial in the description that'll show you how this is done, but for everyone else, our domain name will automatically change to the one we just registered as soon as HostGator have finished setting it up. So that's us now at the end, and that was how to install WordPress on HostGator in 2024. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like here on YouTube to show your support, and consider subscribing to the channel for more WordPress tutorials in future. Once again, my name's Marty from letsbuildwp.com, and thank you very much for watching.